Applications of asymmetric public key cryptography. This video requires concepts from the cryptography video uploaded earlier. Click on the card or link in the description to watch the video on cryptography first. Basically, public key cryptography is used to authenticate or encrypt. Starting with authentication, which is used in digital signatures. Alice is the CEO and she wants to exchange information with the employees of the company. She will generate a private public key pair. This is a one-time process and the new key pairs are only generated if the private key is lost or leaked. She will keep her private key secret and share the public key with all the employees, say Bob 1, 2, 3, and so on. Alice will use her private key to encrypt the message and send it to all the employees. The employees will use Alice's public key to decrypt the message. The fact that Alice's public key is able to decrypt the message implies that the message must have been encrypted using Alice's private key. As only Alice has access to her private key, means the message is definitely sent by Alice. Therefore, it provides authenticity of the source of the message. But the messages are visible to everyone who has the public key. Every message can be read by all the employees, and there is no way to send a message to just one employee. Another use of public key cryptography is to use encryption. To communicate securely, every employee of the company will have to generate their own private public key pair and exchange their public keys. Alice wants to send a message to an employee named Bob. She uses Bob's public key to encrypt the message. The message encrypted by the public key can only be decrypted by the corresponding private key, which is with Bob. Similarly, Bob can reply using Alice's public key to encrypt the message, which can be retrieved only by Alice's private key. Thus, both sides can have encrypted communication, but the authenticity of the source of the message is missing. There is no way to be sure who sent the message, as everyone has access to each other's public key. For most of the applications, both authentication and encryption is required at the same time, which is implemented using more complicated algorithms. Don't forget to go back and finish watching the cryptography video. Like and share the video if you find it useful. Thanks for watching.